To stay alive, we must hide. Do not make a sound. We hide to survive. Whispered words rewind and unwind through my mind, reminders. We are not yet finished. Sometimes suffering carries through generations.
Yes.
Before I knew for sure I was bisexual, I was an ally. I was an advocate. I waved the colors of the rainbow from my lips and spoke idealism like it was my mother tongue.
Oh, yeah.
Equal human rights for equal human love. Simple and pretty clear to my teenage understanding. At the same time, I learned what I knew to be true about being a Jew. Tikkun olam, repair the world. Do what I could do to end the suffering. But we are hidden. Like my ancestors couldn't come out from tight attics or beneath floorboards, we struggle to come out of these closets. Like ghettos, constructed, confined, identified, different. Hitler's troops shamed both parts of me. Like my ancestors couldn't trust their own neighbors or friends, my girlfriend can't tell her own grandparents I exist. We are hidden. We don't hold hands out of fear. 10 months and not one person has witnessed us exchange a kiss. Our love is confined, closeted, boarded up, in attics beneath floorboards kept hidden. There's this quiet assumption that since I'm blonde and blue-eyed and my last name is Thomas, not Berg, Baum, or Stein, that the echoes of the people I hear are not mine. Since I'm a feminine girl, I should be straight. But wait, since I'm with a girl, I should be les, not bi. By what standards are we defined? Assumptions are the slimy reminders of the judgment we fear for ourselves. I'd like to believe I have the power to change this. Maybe I will. But for now, I hear echoes, little whispers lacking the courage of an idealistic teen who doesn't fully understand the depths of her identities. The Star of David and rainbow pin balances points of pride and persecution. Rocking on the edge of confidence and insecurity, I am stumbling out of the closet, wondering if I'll ever be able to casually come out to everyone I meet without testing the waters of tolerance. All I want is to be without thinking, to be without feeling I'm not being me. Whether through silent interrogations or loaded homophobic slurs, I sense a world at war with who I am, telling me to not put it in their faces, to not make a sound. They force me to hide. To stay alive, we must hide. Do not make